joining us in studio next. It's a band currently based in New York. They come by way of Minneapolis. We'll hear their story. Marcy Playground. Been excited about their debut album for several months now. They are in Los Angeles for a show at the Alligator Lounge tonight with Laszlo Bane. Their self-titled album is just out from EMI. We'll be meeting the guys from Marcy Playground in just a few minutes. First off, one live from the studio. Marcy Playground, as Morning Becomes Eclectic on KCRW. Called Poppies, Marcy Playground, live on KCRW's Morning Becomes Eclectic. I'm Chris DeRitas. The band you're hearing is appearing tonight at the Alligator Lounge in Santa Monica with Laszlo Bane. Nice double bill. Look for the self-titled album from Marcy Playground, just out on EMI Records. We are joined by Dan Reeser on drums, Dylan Keefe on bass, John Wozniak, songwriter, guitarist, and vocalist. Good to have you guys in here.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming down.
We're also playing tonight with we're also playing with Chalk Farm.
Chalk Farm's also in the bill.
I think they're heading their headline.
Oh,
the bill,
you see, so. Leave it to me to leave out the headliner.
Yeah. we're only opening too for Laszlo Bane and Chalk Farm. So
you'll be on first.
We'll be on early.
See, we're always more interested in those, you know, the underdogs. What time do you guys go on then? Like 9 o'clock?
Probably, yeah.
Okay.
About 9.
And that'll be a fairly short set, I'm guessing.
That will be like probably a 45-minute set, like 30, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, nonetheless, great to have you here. First question, the obvious one. Marcy Playground, interesting name for a band. There actually was a Marcy Playground that you at least longed to play on in Minneapolis, right?
That's right. I did. I mean, I played on it, but it was a very scary place for a long time.
Marcy Playground is the playground at a school.
Called Marcy.
Marcy Open School.
The Marcy Open School, right. Actually, we just found yesterday, I think it was yesterday, we have a website, and it's marcyplayground.com, and we found a link to to the Minneapolis school system. we're gonna link Marcy Open School's website to our website. So
Marcy Open School is still in existence.
It sure is. Yeah, I mean they tore down several of the buildings. There were two buildings previous to the one that's there now. It's pretty fancy now, pretty new.
The school opened in the late 70s. It was one of these open space schools.
Actually, the late 60s.
Late 60s.
Yeah, okay. Early 70s.
Early 70s. I remember going to an open school in Chicago when I was in sixth grade.
You're kidding.
There were no walls, right?
Well, actually, no. It wasn't one of those open schools. It was but similar. Yeah.
So open was more of a...
It was figurative.
Figuratively. So you called your teachers by their first name?
Exactly,
Bob and Susan.
Right.
Right, okay. And
there were no grades.
No grades.
We all sat around in a circle and, listened to Free to Be You and Me and other records in the back of the... and we had chinchillas.
Chinchillas.
Because every open school program had...
Did they run free or were they...
Actually,
you
know what?
They were caged, were they?
They were caged part of the time, but whenever the kids were... Hang on. No. They were caged at recess when there was nobody around, but when the kids were there, they were out. So.
Out and about.
Yeah, and they were really friendly.
You would have duties like cleaning the erasers, cleaning out the chinchilla cage.
Precisely. and that taught us responsibility. And there was always like a theme, a respect, responsibility, whatever. It was, it was a true hippie school.
So why did you conjure up the name of the playground of the school when forming the band?
I wrote a song called From the Marcy Playground that precedes all of this. I wrote it back in 1991. And, that song doesn't appear on the record, but it appears actually on a previous record that I did in my bedroom. I recorded it in my bedroom. It's just a vanity press. And that song was about all of those emotions that come from that past. And when I was writing the song, I was crying like the whole time I was writing the song.
Wow.
And then we ended up needing a name for the band, and I figured Marcy Playground, man, that's just got to be it, because it really captures what this is about. So
there's so much that's indelible from that time period, I guess, that had a
plenty. Yeah, it's all indelible. My whole childhood I remember like it was yesterday.
I suspect you have trouble putting it into words, and thus the band.
Yeah. Precisely.
So let's just
that's
head
true.
Into it.
Okay.
Marcy Playground's with us. Morning Becomes Eclectic on KCRW.
Ooh, I saw stars falling all around her head, red, gold, and blue. Sherry Fraser, where are you? Cause I saw stars falling all around your head when we were young. Sherry Fraser, where have you gone? Come back and play someday. Sure, yeah. The Mad Hatter, she waits for Alice to come to tea again. She waits forever for his old lover and all. Well, I see stars falling all around your head when you return. Sherry Fraser, what have you learned? Someday.
Good stuff. That's Sherry Fraser from Marcy Playground, live performance on KCRW's Morning Becomes Eclectic. Was there a real Sherry Fraser?
There is. There is.
You are so brutally honest in your stuff.
Yeah. Actually, I try to. If I'm going to write something, it better be about something real, or else, you know.
So
else,
was this,
what's the point?
Was this a girl who you'd throw rocks at on Marcy Playground, or is this somebody?
No.
Okay.
Please, no.
I didn't know how literal we were getting here.
No. She. We were. You know. A thing for 8.5 years, almost 9 years. I met her when I was 15. It was just a magical time in my life. She was my first love, and she's a musician. Actually, she's a classical oboist, and
with the Minneapolis Symphony. Or
something? No. This is actually I met her in Pennsylvania because my dad teaches at Bryn Mawr College out there in Pennsylvania.
All right.
And so I was living out there at that time. And we went to high school together. She actually played with the Nashville Symphony for a while, but not, you know, as like a regular member, but just for, you know, it was like a summer thing that they did. And she was also in the Philadelphia Youth Orchestra and toured China. But I was madly in love with this woman and or girl at the time, and it was just she was a great musician, still is a great musician, and we wrote songs together. In fact, one of the songs on the record was written by her and me, a song called Ancient Walls of Flowers.
So when you wrote this song, she must have heard this by now, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And she was cool with having a song on the album named after her.
She didn't have any choice.
Okay.
I broke her heart, you know, like over and over and over again, and then one time she broke my heart, and it was just this terrible thing. It's like, you know, of course I went in there.
So this is your revenge.
It's not a revenge. It's because we're great friends. I mean, we're great friends now, but it was just a very emotional time, and I wanted to capture that, and so I did.
Marcy Playground is appearing tonight at Alligator Lounge. They'll be opening a triple bill, starting up about 9 o'clock. Marcy Playground hits the stage, 40-minute set or so, then Laszlo Bain. Chalk Farm will close the evening, Alligator Lounge in Santa Monica. We're hearing tracks from the EMI debut release from Marcy Playground. John Wozniak is on the guitar and vocals. We have Dylan Keefe on bass and Dan Reeser on drums. Let's head into the next one. This will be what, Sex and Candy?
No, this will be One More Suicide.
One More Suicide. Marcy Playground in studio.
Christopher Malley went out on the bridge down in Chehalis, clutching his Bible and a letter from her fell into the river. Pity no one was there, no angels in the air, and the morning. Watching her Bible and a letter from him fell into crying. Pity no one was there, no angels in the air, and the morning paper ran. One more suicide. No one was there. No one.
One More Suicide, Marcy Playground, live performance on KCRW's Morning Becomes Eclectic. Is this the first Los Angeles appearance for you guys?
It is, yeah.
Well, welcome. Welcome to Los Angeles. And the show tonight will be, I guess, your second appearance in Los Angeles tonight at the Alligator Lounge starting up about 9 o'clock. Along with Laszlo Bain and Chalk Farm, we have John Wozniak on guitar and vocals, Dylan Keefe on bass, and Dan Reeser on drums. Look for the album out on EMI Records, Marcy Playground, in the in the studio. Now, we're going to head into this one's actually a favorite of mine. I appreciate you guys doing this one. Let's just head into the next one here.
Okay.
Cloak of Elvenkind. Anything you want to say about this? This sounds like it came from
Dungeons and Dragons.
Really?
Yeah. A cloak and boots of Elvenkind. The cloak makes you invisible, and the boots make you silent.
Wow.
It's just a it's one of those things. And
are you a Dungeons and Dragons guy? Are you?
I was. I'm not anymore. I mean, you know, that's one of those things I think you just grow out of. But
hopefully. Otherwise, you know.
It's like, yes, I grew out of Monopoly too. You know, I mean, yeah. It's the same thing, really.
Okay, Marcy Playground in the studio. Cloak of Elvenkind. That is from Marcy Playground. You're hearing a live performance. It's the LA debut from this band who's based in New York. Coming out of Minneapolis, really, John Wozniak on guitar and vocals, and Dylan Keefe on bass, Dan Reeser on drums. John, we mentioned already about the fact that the name of the band, Marcy Playground, is in tribute in a certain way to the Marcy Open School in Minneapolis. Marcy, why was it named Marcy? Is it named after somebody named Marcy? Is it?
Yeah.
Do you know anything about this guy? Is he a famous person from Minneapolis or something?
No. I don't know. I have no idea. I don't know. Okay. You know, they don't teach you that when you're, whatever, in third grade.
Chinchillas are more important.
That's right.
Yeah. Now, you moved to New York at some point and formed the band in New York.
Right.
Right?
That's right. Yeah. That was about 3 years ago I moved to New York. And about 2 years ago, or a year and a half to 2 years ago, we formed the band.
Okay. Put together demos. How'd you end up with EMI Records?
That's kind of a long story, but eventually a tape wound up getting to... actually, a tape of the first thing I did, which I told you about, which has
the song
from the Marcy Playground. A copy of that got to Don Rubin at EMI Records, and he had his interns listening to it, and they liked it. And so he gave it more, you know, whatever, more listening. He gave it a better listening, and he liked it. And then we ended up having Davitt Segerson, who's the president of the label, Brian Kaufman, who's, you know, and Don Rubin, who are both A&R guys. They came out to the house where we were rehearsing and heard us play in a rehearsal, and then afterwards said, okay, we like you guys, let's do something together. And so that's how it really
came
about.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
So now it's unleashed on the public.
All right. Unfortunately.
The album is available.
We're so sorry.
The album is available. I should tell people it's in stores. It's been in stores for several weeks now from EMI Records.
That's right.
And tonight is your only Southern California appearance, right?
We're playing actually in Santa Barbara tomorrow night. What is that place called? Someone's going to help me out.
We'll find it out and let people know in a second.
That's right.
But anyhow, tonight at Alligator Lounge in Santa Monica, tomorrow in Santa Barbara, at a venue to be announced momentarily. But let's head into another song here while we're checking that out. Okay, John?
Oh, it's Toes Tavern.
Toes Tavern?
I was just informed. It's Toes Tavern. So come out and check us out there.
You're reading it through the glass. It may, in fact, be Joe's Tavern, right? No, I'm just kidding.
No, it's Toes.
Okay. Marcy Playground's with us. It's Morning Becomes Eclectic.
Down by myself, and I have so much time to sit and think about myself. And then there she was, like a double cherry pie. Yeah, there she was, like a disco super fly. I smell sexy, can't move it, sure. Who's that lounging in my chair? Who's that casting devious stares in my direction? Mama, this surely is a dream. Yeah, yeah, mama, this surely is a dream. Hanging around downtown by myself, and I've had too much caffeine, and I was thinking about myself, and then there she was, in platform double suede, yeah, there she was, like disco lemonade. I smell sex and candy, yeah. Who's that lounging in my chair? Who's that casting devious stares in my direction? Mama, this surely is a dream. Mama, this surely is a
Marcy Playground, live on KCRW's Morning Becomes Eclectic, Sex and Candy. You can find it on the self-titled album, Marcy Playground, from EMI. You guys are laughing too much. What happened?
We just rocked it out at the end.
I liked it. I liked it. The mama thing was great. Yeah. It's terrific. you can catch them tonight at the Alligator Lounge in Santa Monica with Laszlo Bain and Chalk Farm. They'll be the first band up about 9 o'clock. Then tomorrow at Santa Barbara's Toes Tavern at 8:30 tomorrow night. And I'm going to ask you a favor here. Do you want to take a little diversion here and do a cover?
Sure.
I know that you've been doing something in live performance, a solo
right.
sort of thing here, right?
That's right. It's a cover of Neil Young's The Needle and the Damage Done.
Okay.
You want to hear it?
Yeah. You know, okay. I mean, of all the songs you could pick to, well, I guess it speaks
for itself.
Why
would I?
Yeah.
Because that song is probably just about the best. It's the quintessential. I mean, you can't write a song about heroin any better than that song. I mean, that one really pretty much does it. And that precludes anybody else writing any good songs about heroin as far as I'm concerned.
John Wozniak is with us. He's the lead singer, guitarist, and writer with Marcy Playground. We're hearing a live performance here.
You knocking at my cellar door. I love you, baby. Can I have some more? Oh, the damage done. I hit the city and I lost my band. I watched the needle take another man. Gone, gone. Damage done. I sing this song because I love the man. I know that some of you don't understand. Milk blood to keep from running out. I've seen the needle and the damage done. A little part of it in everyone. But every junkie's like a setting sun.
Neil Young live in the studio here at KCRW. Man, you definitely pull that off, huh? Fantastic. That's actually John Wozniak, lead singer from Marcy Playground, taking on Needle and the Damage Done. Can you do After the Gold Rush for us now?
When I was young and on.
Thanks so much for doing that for us.
Sure.
We're hearing songs from the album Marcy Playground on EMI. Took a little diversion there for a Neil Young cover. And the band is going to be at the Alligator tonight in Santa Monica. And they'll be in Santa Barbara tomorrow night at Toes Tavern for an 8:30 show. And it's been a real pleasure having you guys come out.
Thanks for having us. This has been a lot of fun.
Good. Well, you have to come back.
Okay.
No
problem.
And do you have plans to come back to Southern California?
Of course. Our management is here, and we love to come and see them. And
all right. Well, there. If people miss tonight or tomorrow, then we'll keep them posted on the future.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Come back and see us. It's Marcy Playground in the studio. We're going to go out with one from the album. This is a live performance of a track you'll find on the album, "Dog and His Master."
You'll
anything?
You'll find all these songs on the album that we've been playing, except for the Neil Young.
Except for the Neil Young song. Right. Marcy Playground live. Thanks, guys.
Johnny and James, every boy you see them all going. six little idiots, seven little eight little nine little idiots.